Database for this week is Capstone Interactive. Capstone Interactive is a database of e-titles for students approximately grades reading interest K through 11. There are certain features which we can see here. They have filters like you can search by the popular title, you can search by a newest title. The title, if you know the title, you can do something called a visual search, which means you can go to a category and search by, let's say, graphic novels and do a search, and it will give you all the titles, which were 467 of graphic novels. Now let's just say I wanted to do another type of search, and I wanted to go back into, sorry, cats. Filter is still on for this. Looking for cats, it will give me a list of cats. Here you will see the covers of all the books that pertain to cats or have cat in the title. So I'm going to hit this book, which is Abyssinian Cats. As you see, it will give like a tabs as well as the playbook, which we will get into shortly. The summary gives you a summary of the book, gives you the book information, which is like a quasi mark record with the ISBN, the copyright, the Dewey number. It also gives you good information like what language it's in and the runtime, as well as the Lexile or guided reading level. Another interesting feature is more titles like this. So if there's more titles in a series, it will provide this as well. Once you get into the playbook, it gives you two options to read book page by page and read book all at once. If I go to this, I can actually open the book and you can see the book. Here at the bottom, you have other options like audio and Word. Word highlights anything spoken if the audio is on. So here's an example of that.
Chapter 1, Little Wildcats. When people see Abyssinia,
if you choose not to hear the audio, you can turn it off, which means the word will not play. This is good for students that want to practice their fluency or just read a book on their own. Another great feature is this. These tabs down here is a Read More, which gives you other book title suggestions as well as internet sites from Facttown, which direct the students to other sites that might be useful about the topic. Another great filter is the fact that they have Spanish titles. So if I wanted to go here, I can go and find the Spanish titles. Again, if you do a book, you can go to it. The only drawback that I see with this is the fact that the summary is also listed in English instead of Spanish. For my Spanish readers, this poses an issue. It gives book information again in English and more titles. Since those titles are Spanish, that would be a help. However, you would have to go through the books to see if it was something for you, considering the summary is English instead of Spanish. Drawback with Capstone is, although they do offer Spanish titles, they aren't the same as the English titles. So don't expect to have the same titles in Spanish as you do in English, which could be an issue if students want to read about the same subject or topic. Database is a great resource, and it could be used now to help with supporting readers, as well as giving them more access to books, especially during a time where there's a lot of distance learning going on. And it just gives them extra support in subject matters such as their nonfiction section. Teachers could also use this as supplemental reading, as from my understanding, Capstone does come with some lesson plans which are offered in another site. Hope you enjoyed this. Thank you.